3, 2, 1. Yo, welcome back to the channel, y'all. It's your boy Lenny from Lenny. Yo, Major.
Huh?
Stop talking, bro. Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy Lenny from Lenny and Zoe. Unfortunately, my boy Zoe could not make it today because he has some midterms that he has to straighten out. So my boy will be missing today's video. But show must go on. I got something special for y'all today. We're going to be doing our first reaction video ever. And we're going to be reacting to the famous name Kevin Samuels. I've been on social media a lot lately, so I've been like seeing a lot of the memes and the feedback that I'm getting from him, and this dude is really savage, bro. But yeah, I haven't watched a lot of his videos. I've probably watched like a few clips, but yeah, I'm gonna be live reacting to some of his videos, some of his most savage moments, so you guys are gonna be able to capture it. It's, like I said, guys, we're trying to be productive and we're trying to be consistent as possible, so we're gonna be trying to release content almost every week. So yeah, this is our first reaction video. I hope you guys like it. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on the bell notification so we can keep you guys updated and posted and when we're gonna be posted. Bow. Ooh, I look good reacting to the video. Bow. Let's move.
Hello, intellectual brother, ambitious family.
How tall are you?
I am 5'5".
Do you know what's coming next? Dress size?
Oh my god! Just like that? He just asked her how tall she is. And he just gonna say, you know what's coming next? So he's just that blunt? Yeah, what? Nah, he's wild already? Oh man. It's roller clip, bro. What?
I wear 22. Yeah, I'm juicy. I already know that.
She said she's juicy. Couple short.
Even older women, mm-hmm. As to how to lock down a high value man. You know, you're getting 5,000 plus people watching you asking these questions.
What would be the biggest
takeaway tips you could give to women in the current dating marketplace to lock down a high-value guy?
Stop.
Oh, my stop. God!
Because only 10% of you are going to get it.
Oh! Yo, time out, bro. What? What kind of advice is that? How you going to just tell people to stop? Just stop looking.
Stop it. Get some help.
What? Nah, bro. He said, if you're going to be looking for high-value men, stop looking. Only 10% of you is going to achieve what you're looking for. So that means 90% of the females that's looking for high-valued men is basically going to take this L. Jesus. Yo.
Oh, my God.
Roll the clip, y'all.
I'm sorry, look.
Yo, why the clip so short? Yeah, we gonna find a different video after, bro. Cause what?
I'm 42 years old. Last year I used to weigh 203 pounds.
None.
No, I'm not finished.
None. Yeah, you
not
are.
Last year.
Yeah, you are.
Last year. This year I weighed 165.
No, ma'am. I said you're finished.
Wait, not to body shame anybody, because none of us are perfect. But she says she's 165. That's something wrong with that, bro. Everybody likes a little thickums, a little juice, a little meat on the bone. So I don't agree with him on that one right there, but let's hear what he got to say. What's wrong with 165, bro? That's Gucci, bro. What? Nah, this man's wild, and what he considers perfect, 110 pounds? Listen, we all beautiful in our own shape, form. Everyone is unique in their own way, so I disagree with that. We're not gonna body shame nobody, but he's wildin'. Let's keep it rolling.
You're finished.
I'm done.
Yep.
There's nothing left for me.
Not realistically.
Well, thank you.
Not realistically.
I'm not gonna lie to you. It's the age and the weight. And then if you have any children.
So my kids are...
Okay, ma'am, I don't need to...
Tell me. That's always been a question of mine. Like, say, for example, you're single. Right, and you on the market for dating and all of that good stuff, and then the shorty that you're dating has a kid, but you didn't know that beforehand, and you find out after. Do you continue to pursue her? I've always had mixed signals about that, but if you feel different about that, you could comment on how you feel about that topic. But yeah. Oh, I seen this one.
Do this in public, man. Because you seem like a sweet woman, but you're not getting it.
You're being so mean.
Don't tell me I'm being mean. I'm about to be mean. I get tired of you broads telling me I'm being mean because you cannot handle the goddamn truth. You called my show.
He called the broad.
A call and sat here and tried to help you, and I'm telling.
No way this man just called this woman a bro. He knows this woman from nowhere. And he just gonna call her a bro like that? Come on, bro. Tell me that's not top level savagery. Oh, man. But here's what we gonna do. We gonna switch the video because, you know. We gonna switch the video because he's wildin'. I kind of picked up on a little clip. I started watching a video of him with Joe Budden. And one thing I know about Joe Budden is...
Stop it. Get some help.
He's one of the top savage people that I've ever met. So for the two of these men to collab on a video, that's something crazy. So we're going to switch to that video real quick because I don't like the clips that they're... Matter of fact, we're going to switch it after this last one. So yeah.
You got a big dick?
Huh?
You have a big dick?
That's pause. Suspicious.
Pause. That caught me off guard. What? So I'm guessing he doesn't analyze and judge just women. It's men too that he critiques? I ain't judging no next month, but do you think, Brody? Just like that? But let's get into the video.
I mean, it's above average. I ain't no Ron Jeremy.
No. I asked you if you had a big dick. I just said it was above average.
I don't know what that is, really.
Nigga, you know if you got a big dick or not. Stop the bullshit.
Pause.
Every dude know whether or not he got a big dick. I know I got a big dick. You don't know?
I mean...
You don't have a big dick. That's the point. You don't have a big dick. You don't have a big wallet. You're a fat dude.
Not the bonus.
No, we haven't had sex.
Okay. Why?
Why? Because I don't. I'm stingy. I'm stingy with the puss.
Excuse me.
Whatever she got coming, she low key kind of have it coming for her. So whatever he does say. Just let it rip, bro. Let's hear what you gotta say about that, bro. See, I can't defend. I've been defending everybody else, but oh my god, yo, just go, bro.
I'm stingy with it. I do not give it up easily.
Were you married to your daughter's your baby mama, though, right?
I've never been married, no. But I just okay. Don't,
so
I know
hold on. Let's talk about this though. See, I find it funny that. Women like yourself, baby mamas, all of a sudden want to get stingy with the puss after you done gave your womb up before a ring. But then you want to put in.
You kind of speaking facts, but then again, you can't tell a person what to do with themselves and what to do with their body. Like, you kind of got a point. Like, you, since you, not to say you ran through.
She belongs to the street.
You would have had kids. You had numerous partners. And then now it's my turn. You're going to be stingy? You, come on, bro. Like I said, people could do whatever they want with themselves. You could be as conservative as possible. But when it's my turn, you're going to be stingy? Come on, Brody. Don't do that. Like, come on, bro.
She belongs to the street.
Now you're just being grimy, bro. But yeah, go do your thing, Kevin.
Put a ring on it before he gets it?
So am I supposed to give it away?
You goddamn right you already did. Because here's the thing. See, that's what I mean. Ma'am, you're a used vehicle wanting
Yo, bro, did not just call Shorty a used vehicle. Yo, he did not just call her a used vehicle, bro. This man is disrespectful, bro. What? Nah. He did not just call Shorty a used vehicle.
2021 prices. You can laugh all you want to, ma'am, but you just said 6 months. You're not even exclusive. You're talking about he's marriage-minded. What do you think he's inserting his penis? In his hand?
No, that's the thing. He could be inserting it somewhere else.
Exactly, because here's the thing. Men with options don't play these games.
Mm-hmm. I saw it. That was the end of the first video. I was going to do like 2-3 minutes, a couple minutes of the Joe Budden and their collab. So,
I've always loved sci-fi.
But yeah.
And the idea of being...
What do you guys think about him?
Discovery and frontiers.
I feel like... This is not a persona. He's being dead serious. I'm guessing this is exactly who this man is. He's not putting up a front. This is who he portrays to be. He's just as blunt as can be. And that's a good thing. But that could get you in a lot of trouble as well. But, bro, do you, Brody? Do you, Brody? Why the commercials so long, bro?
Really, nigga?
Really, bro? Really, bro?
It's falling apart. And people are not getting together here, other places, the hookup economy, all these things are existing. And here's the thing. Women are unhappy with the outcomes. Women are vocal about their women have no problem being vocal about the things they don't like.
Right.
Men
have learned not to say anything. You fuck.
What he just said there? That's 100% facts.
Message.
That is 100% facts. Women, they'll let you know when things is not going the way it's supposed to go. They'll let you know when you're messing up. But men, a man would, to spare the relationship and to spare females' feelings, they'll take whatever is being dished out to them and they're gonna troop it through, which is not a good thing, which is very toxic.
Stop it.
And it can like really destroy a person, but what he's saying is facts. I guess he's not so savage in this, so he's just basically speaking fact.
Right, we did.
Yeah. You can't say that.
Yeah, we did.
Because, no, I agree.
Some of me has to believe that you have to subscribe to some of the myths of the woman that you want to sleep with.
Well, I will say this. Men have learned that if I say too much truth, I will be canceled. I'll lose
money. I'll lose deals. I'll lose this. Especially
entertainment.
Yes. Who buys the concert tickets and the shirts and everything else? So men in a business interest, we're practical. We're cost-benefit calculators. What's the benefit to what I'm going to say versus the cost? Now, what's happened is, I hate the term social media. Social media has happened. So it has democratized the access to the airwaves. The smartphone and high-speed internet access has taken away has leveraged the power that the TV stations, the cable stations, and the radio stations.
This is clearly not the video that we were looking for. This is more an informative video and not so much a critique and advice column video like he normally does. So we're gonna put a pause in the video. We're gonna end it at there. Like the video. Thank you for joining us. Let me know if you guys like this type of content so I can continue to do more, or I can branch off into a different space. But yeah, like I said, we're gonna be as consistent as possible. From time to time, we're gonna be doing videos, me and Zoe together, and sometimes it's gonna be me by myself, and sometimes it's gonna be Zoe. That way, when one of us is not able to work, we'll still have content for you guys, and we'll always be able to post. But yeah, thank you guys for joining us. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and turn on the bell notification. Thank you. Hope you guys liked the video. Bow. Love you guys.